Hello, good morning. Welcome on He is Coming 12. I will read to you a wonderful message. Hello, on September 9th, 2012, the messenger angel of God brought on this message to Benjamin Kausijnsen. Shalom, Benjamin Kausijnsen. I greet you in the name of Yeshua HaMashiach. I'm the messenger angel of God, and my name is Raphael. You there, listen carefully. I tell you, I was once sent out with a mission of God. I found myself among the travelers. These people pitched their camp again elsewhere, and they had also many caravans. In the evening, they made fire sometimes, and they sang songs together from the ancient times. Whether you believe me or not, I sat there by the fire and talked to a couple, Esmeralda and Anton. I told them that many people think that with all their good deeds, they may so enter heaven. This is a lie. Do you have a Bible? I asked. Go get it. Then let me show you Isaiah 64, verse 6. Esmeralda took me but for a strange traveler, and I knew what she was thinking, but they did not know who I was. Esmeralda returned with the Bible. She said that there was hardly anyone who could read and write. This I knew, of course, and read to them from Isaiah 64, verse 6. There it was written, "For we are all become as one who is unclean, and all our righteousness are as a polluted garment, and we all do fade as a leaf, and our iniquities, like the wind, take us away." I also said that it is precisely the sin which brings separation between man and God and his plan for man. In Isaiah 57, verse 20 and 21, it says, "But the wicked are like the troubled sea, which cannot rest, and its waters cast up mire and dirt. There is no peace, says my God, to the wicked." Anton and Esmeralda stood listening with their mouths open, just because their deeds were so many, and they thought to inherit the kingdom of God like that. I talked a lot about Yeshua HaMashiach, the Christ, with them at this campfire, and also read John 11, verse 25 to 28 for them. Jesus said to her, "I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet he shall live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. Do you believe this?" She said to him, "Yes, Lord, I have believed that you are the Christ, the Son of God, who has come into the world." This couple was never taught about this. Late in the evening, they were baptized in the lake by me, and they gave their lives to him that also loves you. Why was I there, do you think? The reason also was that this couple was killed by a fire in a caravan. After I had been there, the God of Isaac, Jacob, and Abraham was searching for their hearts, and they gave their hearts to Jesus Christ. They were allowed to enter heaven, and they were allowed to enter their new home. We messenger angels of God are also often sent to save people from the clutches of hell. I tell you, have you already made a choice? Do it now then. Fold your hands and ask Jesus to forgive all your sins. Name it. Invite him into your life. Give your heart to him and become a child of God. And find a church that is full of the fire of God. Skip the churches which are not open to the three-course menu. There are too many churches with porridge. You cannot grow from that. If you have asked for forgiveness, you must also maintain your faith. Read your Bible and talk a lot with him. He asks for your attention. Benjamin, God loves all the camp residents. God looks at the heart, not at the outside. I'm going now. Ruwacha, Yeshu, Shalom, said the messenger angel of God and disappeared. God bless you. Shalom.